Good evening. Welcome to our second Advent meditative service for this Advent season. Advent means coming, and we are making our way towards Christmas and the coming of the baby Jesus. Every week during Advent, we light a candle to remind us of the virtues that Jesus brought with him and advocated. These virtues are symbolized by the four candles that we light. They represent hope, love, joy, and peace. So tonight, in addition to the candle of hope, we will light the candle of peace. May its glow remind us of God's tender care for us and the warmth that comes from within us as we shine God's light on those in need of being reminded of peace in our world. Hear now a reading from Psalm 25. To you, O Lord, I lift up my soul. O my God, in you I trust. Do not let me be put to shame. Do not let my enemies exult over me. Do not let those who wait for you be put to shame. Let them be ashamed who are wantonly treacherous. Make me to know your ways, O Lord. Teach me your paths, lead me to your truth, and teach me, for you are the God of my salvation. For you, I wait all day long. Be mindful of your mercy, O Lord, and of your steadfast love, for they have been from of old. Do not remember the sins of my youth or my transgressions. According to your steadfast love, remember me. For your goodness' sake, O Lord. Good and upright is the Lord. Therefore, he instructs sinners in the way. He leads the humble in what is right and teaches the humble his way. All the paths of the Lord are steadfast love and faithfulness for those who keep his covenant and his decrees. This evening, our reading is from the book of Isaiah, chapter 61, verses 1 through 4 and 8 through 11. I invite you, as I do on Sunday mornings, to close your eyes and listen for something new that God might be wanting you to hear from our reading this evening. The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me, because God has anointed me. He has sent me to bring good news to the oppressed, to bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives and release to the prisoners, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor and the day of vengeance of our God, to comfort all who mourn, to provide for those who mourn in Zion, to give them a garland instead of ashes, the oil of gladness instead of mourning, the mantle of praise, instead of a faint spirit. They will be called oaks of righteousness, the planting of the Lord to display his glory. They shall build up the ancient ruins. They shall raise up the former devastations. They shall repair the ruined cities, the devastations of many generations. For I, the Lord, love justice. I hate robbery and wrongdoing. I will faithfully give them their recompense, and I will make an everlasting covenant with them. Their descendants shall be known among the nations and their offspring among the peoples. All who see them shall acknowledge that they are a people whom the Lord has blessed. I will greatly rejoice in the Lord. My whole being shall exult in my God, for he has clothed me with the garments of salvation. He has covered me with the robe of righteousness, as a bridegroom decks himself with a garland, and as a bride adorns herself with her jewels. For as the earth brings forth its shoots, and as a garden causes what is sown in it to spring up, so the Lord God will cause righteousness and praise to spring up before all the nations.
Thank you.
My friends, we will now move into prayers of intercession. There will be an opportunity in the midst of our prayers for silent time for you to offer your own personal prayers. As I go through the start of these prayers, I invite you to respond, God be with us, to each petition. Again, that is God be with us. My dear ones, let us be in prayer together. God, we seek you in the most unlikely places, as a child in a stable and in an empty tomb. Hear these prayers which come from the unlikely corners of our lives and hearts. Let us have hope that darkness and death do not have the final say. God be with us. Let us prepare for the miraculous birth of the Word in our hearts. God be with us. Let us live into the joy of this life and the promise of God's return. God be with us. Let us love God and our neighbors with all our hearts, minds, and spirits. God be with us. I now invite us into a time of silence and personal prayers. Oh God, give us ears to hear and eyes to watch, that we may know your presence in our midst during this holy season of joy, as we anticipate the coming of Jesus Christ, who taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Thank you. Kindly join me in prayer. O holy God, as we continue this darkest time of the year, we see the night sky reflected in our world, from a full, beautiful moon to a starless, cloudy, rainy night. Help us to remember your promise. Shine your light upon us, warming our hearts and our souls. Live among us and do what we cannot. Bring peace, counsel the nations, lift up the poor and forgotten, and bring low those who are proud. Come again, God, come again, and change our hearts. Let us go this night in the hope that God will be born anew in our world and in our hearts. Amen.